Well, hello there, people, and welcome from the darkness of the Danish lands. Don't take this video too seriously. I'm just trying to prove a point. But I had a conversation with about bloatware on the Windows and stuff like that, and adds unwanted installations of programs, call it bloatware, call it advertisement and stuff like that. Windows, I think, comes with Candy Crush, Facebook, Teams. It comes with a lot of apps. That's the word I'm looking for. Apps pre-installed so the user can start to use the system. And the Linux community love to bitch and moan about, oh my God, it has Candy Crush installed, it has Twitter installed by default and all these things, and see that as advertisement bloatware. And it kind of is. It is a form of advertisement and it is a kind of bloatware. Do Linux have bloatware? Linux don't, so to speak, have ads. There are some things you can regard a little bit like ads, like when you install Ubuntu, it kind of, and I think it's not only Ubuntu, I think it's a GNOME thing, but they want you to sign in with your social media accounts. That could be looked a little bit like, oh, you should use these social media accounts. Yeah, I know that's not the intention, but it could be looked like that. If you're a totally new user and you have no fucking idea, you could be like, do I need all those social media accounts? You know, you get what I'm saying here? I know it's reaching a little bit, but it could be misinterpreted. So ads, you know, advertisement for the latest blue pill or, you know, for the latest dating site and stuff like that. No, we don't get that in Linux. We don't really get that in Windows either. So let's explore, do Linux have bloatware? And let's define bloatware. It's basically ads that you don't want. It's undesirable ads, or it's ads that you don't need. Candy Crush, a lot of people like playing Candy Crush. A lot of people like to use the Twitter app on Windows. A lot of people like to use the pre-installed ads on the Windows. So for them, it's not bloatware. For you, it may be, and you can uninstall all of them. Windows had a problem where Candy Crush got reinstalled after an update. It don't do that anymore. I can confirm that. So let's look at Linux. Do Linux come with bloatware or software you don't need or you don't want, or some people don't need or some people don't want? And I just happen to have Linux Mint. I just picked the first ISO I found on my hard drive. That was Linux Mint. So let's go in here and let's just look at accessories. Redshift. Do I need that? Text editor. Do I need that? I know I'm reaching here, but hold on with me a little bit. Graphics. Document scanner. How many people have a scanner nowadays? Not a lot of people. So that would be a program that I would be like uninstalling right away. And I do that on all my Linux machines. When I run Linux, I take away stuff like the document scanner. I don't have a scanner, and most of the people I know don't have a scanner. And printers and scanners are dying out. I'm sorry to say it. Pix, what is this? It looks like it's a picture organizer, like a Lightroom. Some people may not need that, so for them, that's bloatware. Internet, Hexchat. Who the fuck uses Hexchat in 2022? There are people out there doing it, don't get me wrong, but for a lot of people, that would be bloatware. It would be undesirable, so I uninstall that also. Transmission. Not many people download from Tolls anymore. I will uninstall that also. Web apps is like their version of ICE. I will uninstall that. Some people may like it. But for me, I already see four bloatware in here. I will uninstall web apps, Transmission, Thunderbird, and Hexjet. For me, that's bloatware. That's undesirable hardware, software. Office, LibreOffice. I uninstall the whole LibreOffice suite. Most casual users that do documents do it now in the cloud. So for me, LibreOffice is massive bloatware, and it's almost 1 GB full. If you ever have respinned your own distribution, you will notice that LibreOffice actually takes up quite a big chunk of your ISO size. Would I prefer a link in the menu that when you click it, it will download LibreOffice and then delete itself or uncheck itself so it's not in the menu anymore? Preferably, but for a lot of people, it's a tool or a program they would not be needing. So therefore, it's unuseful space. it's bloatware. You know, it's there to do no good. So, and also, it could be seen as an advertisement because, oh, we have LibreOffice. Maybe people would use LibreOffice if it's in the system. So it's a little bit underhanded advertisement or playing a little bit on the human psyche and saying, like, it's here, play with us. You don't need that pesky Google Docs and stuff like that. Hypernonics in sound is a free television service-esque thing. I would uninstall that. Don't need that. Bloatware, in my opinion. You may use it, but for me, it's bloatware. Rhythmbox, you may use it. For me, bloatware. And that's kind of it here. And I haven't installed Linux Mint. And I know you can do a minimum install. But the point that I'm trying to say here is that if you're criticizing Windows for installing a lot of pre-installed apps that you may not like Facebook app, Twitter app, Spotify app, if that's pre-installed, Teams and stuff like that, you should also criticize Linux, a Linux distribution, for installing applications you don't use, because they may be unuseful for you, but they may be useful for me. I don't fault a Linux distribution for having any of this installed, because like I said, these are probably a lot of people that probably like to run at least, I would not even say LibreOffice, but maybe Rhythmbox. I could see a lot of people wanting Rhythmbox. And Hypernotix, the free TV station thingy application, is quite, it's a good little entertaining program to watch, you know, watch a little bit TV online on. I don't fall that. LibreOffice, I would say, is plowed. I will regard LibreOffice as plowed, because just look at how many people are using Google Docs or Microsoft, Office 365 in the cloud. So I will regard that as plowed, because it's a big mammoth and nobody really uses it. Another one would be Thunderbird. I think that's between 400 to 600 megabyte. It takes off ISO. Honestly, almost nobody is using email clients on their desktop anymore. Not Windows users, not Mac users, and not Linux users. I know there are people out there that still do it. If you're one of them, then it's not bloatware for you. But if the majority don't do it, could it be regarded as bloatware? Or unnecessary software installed on an ISO? Or installed under an installed and Hexchat? Not that big, but it's definitely something that's almost unnecessary. If you're criticizing one system for doing something, in now we're talking bloat application or installing undesirable applications, you should also do that for the Linux systems. I'm a little bit fed up with this mentality of it's not okay. It's okay if we do it, but it's not okay if they do it. We have to be consistent with our criticism. See you all later. Bye bye.